Yes, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Frankie Guzman. I'm the director of the Youth Justice Initiative at the National Center for Youth Law, and I'm here to speak in support of the legislature and SB 823. Last year, the legislature passed and the governor signed into law Senate Bill 823, which set into motion the closure of DJJ, thereby transferring the responsibility for serving all youth in California's juvenile justice system to the counties and providing significant funding to counties to carry out this plan. Recognizing the challenges and opportunities, as well as the need for oversight and accountability for counties' use of state funding and for the treatment of all incarcerated youth, Senate Bill 823 also established the Office of Youth and Community Restoration, or OYCR, to oversee the entire juvenile justice system across the 58 counties. Senate Bill 823 clearly outlines the roles and responsibilities of the OYCR to include state oversight of all juvenile justice systems across the 58 counties, administration of the realignment block grant funding, and eventually all of the state's juvenile justice grant programs, data collection and reporting on outcomes for all youth in the juvenile justice system, identifying policy recommendations to best support all youth in the juvenile justice system, and identifying and disseminating best practices, again, for all youth in the juvenile justice system, providing technical assistance to counties to meet the needs of all youth in the juvenile justice system, and to establish an ombudsperson to investigate complaints from all incarcerated youth, their families, staff, and others about the harmful conditions, practices, and violations of law in local facilities. Inexplicably, the governor's administration now seeks to depart from the state law and from the governor's own commitment to move California's youth justice system towards a health-based model in important ways. First, the governor's administration's interpretation of Senate Bill 823 severely limits the scope of the OYCR and omits many of its critical responsibilities, including but not limited to the responsibility to develop and expand local diversion opportunities and to identify policy recommendations for improved outcomes and integrated programs and services to best support all delinquent youth. Also, the governor's administration's interpretation of SB 823 dramatically limits the scope of the ombudsperson's role and responsibilities, including limiting its protections to only youth with designated offenses or youth who otherwise would have been incarcerated in DJJ prior to 2007. However, state law is clear that all youth in juvenile justice system facilities will be provided with the protections of the ombudsperson. The administration's erroneous interpretation of clearly defined law, if implemented, would be illegal and would likely result in misuse of state funds, the maltreatment of vulnerable incarcerated youth, and costly litigation to correct any deficiencies or abuses that occur out of local practices that result from a lack of oversight and accountability. Even more concerning is the governor's budget requests only 19 permanent positions and a meager $3.4 million general fund allocation in 2021-22 and $3.1 million ongoing thereafter to establish and operate the OYCR. Whether a result of a misinterpretation of clearly defined law or an attempt to undermine the state's ability to oversee, support, and hold accountable county systems, the governor's administration's narrow interpretation and proposed under-resourcing of OYCR must be corrected. I urge the legislature to maintain the state's commitment to providing meaningful oversight and accountability for counties' practices and support the improvement of the entire juvenile justice system to ensure the well-being of all young people in that system, and fully resourcing OYCR to carry out all of its duties. Thank you.